they have something. Your father was working on a project called Janus before he died. They've replicated his research. They have it. They're going to test it.
And what does Janus do?
I swear I don't know.
Vaccinations are already underway in the UK. CBS senior foreign correspondent Liz Palmer reports.
I have really good news. Today our nation has achieved a medical miracle. We have delivered a safe and effective vaccine in just 9 months. This is one of the greatest scientific accomplishments in history. It will save millions of lives and soon end the pandemic once and for all. I am thrilled to report that the FDA has authorized the Pfizer vaccine.
To this day, we have a commander-in-chief of the United States of America who is holding rallies with no mask.
Caught on camera, House Speaker Nancy Pelosi seen getting her hair done inside a San Francisco salon, something that goes against the city's health order, and it's all captured on surveillance video.
America is making a choice between President Donald Trump and former Vice President Joe Biden.
And Tate, what did he say?
He said that this is the end. He said that we are all finished. And he took his own life.
The Electoral College votes, which occurred today, reflect the fact that even in the face of a public health crisis unlike anything we've experienced in our lifetimes, the people voted.
Joe Biden has won the American presidential election. The BBC projects that he's crossed the threshold of 270 electoral college votes needed with a win in the state of Pennsylvania.
And I discussed that with him and I told him I thought that was a good idea.
He also said when he spoke to you, he asked you to continue in your role, which you've had under six presidents, but also to serve as his chief medical advisor. Will you do that? Did you say yes?
Oh, absolutely. I said yes right on the spot. Yeah.
But there is no detailed plan that we've seen anyway as to how you get the vaccine out of a container into an injection syringe into somebody's arm. And it's going to be very difficult for that to be done in this very expensive proposition.
Coronavirus relief spending is bogged down again in Congress, and that is very bad news for people in danger of being evicted. The CDC has put a temporary hold on all evictions in an effort to protect public health and prevent the spread of COVID-19. But that order expires on December 31st. If it is not extended, 30 to 40 million Americans could lose their homes.
We have fabricated a worldwide flu scare. We are about to manufacture enough vaccine to inoculate the planet. But because you have kept us waiting, we now have just under 3 months in which to do that. It's just about possible. Tomorrow will be too late.
She's all I have left of him.
Acceptance on the part of various elements in our society. You know, particularly, and we're working very hard, minority populations understandably have somewhat of a skepticism. I've been out there, my colleagues have been out there, trying to outreach to this group of individuals and explain to them the things that make them skeptical are, for example, the speed with which this has happened. That's a really good thing, Gail, because the speed is a reflection of the extraordinary scientific advances.
COVID-19. Blacks and Latinos are three times as likely to die if they get COVID-19. And so the communities of color, it's a mass casualty event. And so we've got to figure out how we make sure we get the vaccine to those communities.
Citizens, there are 120 guns across mainland United States. It almost seems, when you look at it from the outside, that America seems to be preparing for a kind of civil war. This is not going to be an ordinary peaceful election, but at least in the United States, there is apprehension that over the next several hours and days, the situation in the US could get violent and grim.
We'll be right back.
The circumstances are unprecedented in American history. A country battling its first public health crisis in a century.
Not for no reason. This is vindication for a lot of people who have really suffered. You know, the I can't breathe. You know, that wasn't just George Floyd. That was a lot of people that felt that they couldn't breathe.
To do what I do, I need some idea of the threat we face.
As I understand it, we're trying to prevent World War III.
No, wait, let me think.
What is there to think about?
There isn't another version of this waiting in the wings. There isn't another Jeff or another flu scare or another vaccine or virus. This is it.
Tonight, defiant and denying his own defeat, President Trump answered questions for the first time since Election Day.
I don't know what is going to happen. I know one thing, Joe Biden did not get 80 million votes.
Thinking it's okay to lose so many lives. Is that thinking that, I mean, losing that much life is never acceptable. But losing some is. Places where a virus could be released and controlled without risk of spread to the wider population. See, she was wrong, Michael. You don't need a pandemic for people to take the vaccine. Just need the fear of a pandemic.
70 record closing highs so far for the Dow.
Blasting through a ceiling.
In a record-setting IPO.
So this is how liberty dies. With thunderous applause.